Okay, so it's been quite a while since I've been in Star Wars The Old Republic. At least as part of a recorded video. I have been reacquainting myself with the game since the last expansion release, and we've now got the War for Iokath, which launched a few days ago from when I'm recording this. I haven't really been doing much with the game, like, since... Well, yeah, since I last released those Knights of the Eternal Throne episodes, which was... God, was that last year? Was that before Rogue One and stuff came out? I can't remember. But yeah, I wanted to kind of play the War for Iokath and go through that and put those episodes, you know, record those and put them up as episodes for the channel. I haven't played Mass Effect Andromeda in about 2 weeks. I'm kind of annoyed with the game because every time I try and record, basically the game just doesn't work. The game is, as far as I'm concerned, freaking broken. There is a constant kind of... Yeah, just... The frame rate issues and things like that are more of an issue than I would like. And I'm kind of wanting to go back to a game that... that actually runs well. So... I'm kind of in two minds. I might carry on with... my Mass Effect 3 playthrough, but then I do kind of want to complete Andromeda, so I don't know. I'm kind of in between two things at the moment, and I'm not quite sure which route to take. But enough about that, enough about the rest of it. I did just look it up, and yes, the Knights of the Eternal Throne episodes were done in December last year, so they were before Rogue One came out, which I think if you watched some of my Mass Effect episodes that came out around then, I think I was still doing the first Mass Effect then. I wasn't a big fan, which is a bit disappointing because I loved The Force Awakens. Not a great fan of Rogue One, though. Doesn't bode well for the Han Solo movie, but I've loved the trailer for The Last Jedi. I think Rian Johnson's a great director, so I'm not too worried. But yeah, as for Star Wars The Old Republic, in preparation for the War for Iokath, I have been getting used to the game again. My Sith warrior character is now up to date. I finished doing the Knights of the Eternal Throne storyline with him 2 days ago, I think. And then I've also been working on my Jedi Consular character. So, I have been playing the game a little bit over the last week or so. As I say, just to try and remember what the game's like so I don't look like a complete Wazzuk whilst playing this. But yeah, so I'm kind of done with this little intro. And let's actually start the War for Iokath, shall we? I haven't played this at all yet, so haven't a bloody clue what the storyline is, what you gotta do, how long it is. Step into the unknown. I'm hoping it's not going to be too short. I don't think it's like a huge, huge expansion. Maybe it is. I don't know. I don't think it's got like a million and one episodes, but we'll give it a go. Oh, hello, pop-in textures. Thank you. I was kind of hoping I'd look like a badass sitting in a throne, but there we go.
The Eternal Alliance is stronger than ever, Commander.
Awesome.
More worlds sign up every day. Name any planet Valen terrorized, and we're helping them recover. Speaking of which, Zakul contacted us again. They're asking for more aid.
Okay. I mean, to be fair, we have kind of liberated them from a insane tyrannical emperor who's ruled over them for, in one form or another, like 1,000 years, so they're probably deserving of it.
Zakul suffered as much as anyone. Make sure they get everything they need.
Done and done.
You're holding out on me, Theron. What's the status of our mission to Iokath?
I was saving the best for last. Lana should be closing in on the superweapon right about now.
I like the sound of that. A superweapon, you say? Last time I remember, Iokath was pretty much meant to be uninhabitable.
Come in, Lana. How's the radiation sickness treating you?
It's nothing I can't handle. Isn't that right, C6?
Worried and melodramatic. That sounds about right.
Droid.
Lana equals full of herself.
Focus on the mission. Have you found the superweapon, Lana?
According to the intel we received, it should be just up ahead. Stand by.
Kind of a bit worried that the Alliance is now going in for super weapons.
Target located. Commencing scan. Power levels are off the charts and rising by the second. Incredible.
Contact.
They're meant to be the good guys, right? That was the Republic.
What's happening?
I've got company.
What's the Republic doing here?
And why are they shooting at us? I'd say that's the more pressing question.
The Sith Empire. They must be after the superweapon.
Oh, great. So the Sith and the Republic are back at...
back online. Hurry.
Fighting
working
again.
On it.
Why can't they just play nice? Stop reverting to type.
Don't worry, I lost them.
Lost who?
The Sith Empire and the Republic. Whom? They're on Iokath, and they appear to be fighting for control of the superweapon.
They'll stand down if they know what's good for them. Get me Empress Asena, and whoever's leading the Republic forces these days.
That would be Supreme Commander Jace Malcolm.
Judging by enemy comm traffic, it sounds like Asena and Malcolm are leading the charge on Iokath.
So much for our alliance with the Empire. That superweapon must be quite the prize.
According to my scans, it's more powerful than anything we've ever encountered.
More powerful than the Eternal Throne?
Quite possibly. If the Republic or Empire claim it, they would usurp the Eternal Alliance as the dominant power in the galaxy. The fallout would be catastrophic.
The Republic champions peace, not galactic domination. They wouldn't start now.
Are you absolutely sure? After Valen, they're more desperate than ever to reclaim their lost.
And
power.
We don't know what this new guy's like.
And they aren't exactly shy about using super weapons.
Then we have no choice. We can't let this weapon fall into the wrong hands.
How should we proceed, Commander?
We'll meet you on Iokath, Lana. Head for the fleet spire and start clearing a landing zone.
Understood. I'll see you soon.
Roger, roger.
Ships of the Eternal Fleet, stop all supply runs to Imperial and Republic worlds and join me on Iokath. We have a war to win.
Oh, great. So let's fight both the Sith Empire and the Republic, because that's not going to end badly for anyone.
Hello, Iokath. You're looking as dangerous as ever.
Something's wrong. The Imperial and Republic fleets aren't attacking each other.
Are they going to attack us?
No, no. Something is scrambling our weapon systems. It's coming from the planet's surface, near the superweapon.
Why do I think this is a trap?
The Eternal fleet's offline, Commander. They can't help us.
Tell the Gemini captains to find a workaround. In the meantime, we'll head to the surface and establish a landing zone.
Good call. If there's any way to help our fleet, we'll find it on Iokath.
Why do I get the impression that the Sith and the Republic are just going to turn their weapons on us? Unless their weapons are out as well. That would make more sense. I'm guessing that weapons on the planet aren't disabled, and just weapons on ships in orbit. Because otherwise combat's not going to be very fun. Just going around twatting people in the face, that'll be... Actually, that sounds quite enjoyable. Right, so, let's make our way to whatever it is we got to do. Defeat the Scours. Oh great, a boss battle already. Oh, there we go. God, I haven't played my, what's this character called again? My Jedi Knight character in a long, long time. I was wondering, actually, I wonder how much they have to pay Troy Baker. Because he's kind of a big deal now in voice acting. I'm kind of like wondering if they've got him on some kind of special contract where they just had to pay him like the amount that they were paying him like 4 years ago when he first joined the game. Actually, no. When did? Because he's actually a companion character for the Jedi Consular, so he would have been on board from the very first day. So he would have been... Ooh. 2010, I think this game came out, so... Maybe it's 2012. I think Star Trek Online was 2010. But yeah. Just trying to remember what the moves are for this character. I haven't, really used her at all whilst I've been reacquainting myself with the game. It was a little bit confusing actually whilst I was in orbit and they were saying about contacting Scorpio, because when I've been catching up with my Sith character, we killed Scorpio. In fact, we killed a lot of people.
Safe before we make camp here.
Understood. May the Force ever serve you.
In fact, I think the only person we didn't kill was Lana, Theron, and a few other minor characters. Koth died, Scorpio died, who else died? Loads of people died. Basically, anybody that we could kill ended up being dead. So, my Sith character, not the nicest of people. Let's see where we're actually going. I think that might be a better idea.
Immense purification.
I will say I'm probably not going to... unless something magically happens in the next sort of... few hours of my playthrough with my... Jedi Consular character. I don't think I'll be bringing that character up to date. I think I might just complete, like, the class story stuff, like, the more unique class levels. Maybe do, like, Revan and things like that, but I'm probably not going to do Knights of the Eternal Throne, Knights of the Fallen Empire with them, because it's so long-winded, and it's no different. I'm just going to be retreading stuff that I already know. So I very much doubt I'll be doing complete playthroughs with every single character. I think I might keep my Sith character and my, obviously my Jedi Knight character up to date, but as for the rest of it, probably not. Can I avoid them? Not really. I was hoping that we'd get more of a mention of the Old Republic at Celebration. I know that it's, you know, they had a lot of stuff on with Battlefront, things like that, which does look really good, by the way. Not quite sure yet if I'm going to get it at launch. I might wait for the reviews. I've got the first slash, well, I guess third Battlefront game. The most recent one, for PS4, and it was alright for a time in that kind of, like, post The Force Awakens, Star Wars-based kind of obsessive period that you always get when something massive that you fall in love with is released. But, yeah, I can't say I've really touched the game in about 7 months? Yeah, it's that game's pretty much dead for me. I haven't bought any of the DLC, which, you know, a lot of people would say, yeah, well, too bloody right, DLC's a ripoff, but I don't have a problem with it. I know a lot of people get up in arms about it, but it's not something that particularly bothers me. You know, fair play if it does to you. You've got probably slightly more stringent moral standards than I do, but I'm kind of like, yeah. If people are going to get season passes and stuff, or if people are going to buy DLC, give them a season pass. Like, I don't really mind. It's no skin off my nose, but yeah. It's one of the things that bugs me with, what was it? Was it? I think it was all of BioWare's stuff. They don't really go in for season passes. None of the Mass Effect games had a season pass. I don't think Andromeda does either, now that I think of it. And none of the original trilogy did either, so, which was a bit of a pain in the ass when I rebought them all on PC. After having originally got a load of the DLC on bloody Xbox. And they don't do Game of the Year editions, although they did do one for Dragon Age Inquisition. Picked that up for a fiver from Game on PC, which was friggin' bargain. But yeah, I'm a bit of a BioWare fanboy, you may have noticed. Apparently, except for Mass Effect Andromeda, which I don't hate, I'm just kind of bored of. I'm hoping that this will get me back in the mood for playing BioWare's, like, more recent offerings. I'm kind of like, yeah, not done with Andromeda, but kind of put off. I do know that in this we are able to get some old companions back. None of my Jedi Knight companions yet. You kind of get shafted if you choose the Jedi Knight characters. The only companions that have come back, I think, for the Jedi Knight were the droids, which don't even really count. In fact, yeah, droids don't count. I'm sorry, they just don't. Most of the, like, all the three main bloody characters, the companions that I liked, are mainly used, Doc, Carson, and Scourge. Nowhere to be seen. So, yeah, kind of, that's a bit shit. I would love Kira to come back. I really liked her character. I'm kind of glad I've got stuff to talk about as well, because this is long-winded.
Probe. Record. Let me give you a hand. Dispose.
I'd forgotten as well with this character that the force points, the focus, sorry, not for force points, the focus goes down really quickly. You kind of need to be up on your regeneration of force points. Because a lot of things that I would use... use up a lot of points. Stuff like Crashing Blast uses a lot. Blade Rush uses a lot. I think Lance does as well, although maybe not, I'm not sure. But yeah, you have to either use Zealous Strike or just your standard attack to kind of really regenerate your points, which is not great. It has to be said. One thing I do miss as well is that there isn't a lift, like an immobilization move. You do have, like when you're with the Sith character, you've got Force Push, which is fantastic. Especially if you're near tall ledges. But yeah, with this one, you don't really have any kind of move that does that, I don't think. I don't know what these things I'm picking up are. Iokath power shards. Command tokens. I don't really understand what these do. Large amount of reputation. Small amounts of reputation. Eh, fair enough. They have kind of revamped the upgrade system, which... I must say, does not seem that intuitive to me. Your standard crystals and stuff seem to be quite straightforward. I understood them. Maybe it's just because that was what I was used to. But, yeah. I haven't really looked into this new system yet. But then I'm not what they call a min-maxer. I don't try and get the most out of my equipment. I just kind of go with what looks cool and what's easy to get a hold of and what uses the biggest numbers. But yeah, it's like if I don't like the look of my character, chances are I'm probably not going to be that invested in them. As it is, I think all my characters look pretty freaking cool. I'll try and show you a picture of my Sith character who I've made look rather evil. I kind of like my characters to look like what they're supposed to look like. Although for as much as evil as my Sith character looks, they are not pure evil. They have not maxed out their dark side alignment. And not even like a little bit just below. It's actually only on just past level 4, I think. So for anybody unfamiliar, you've got your alignment there. So like my Jedi character is full light side alignment. They are a paragon of virtue. But my Sith character is kind of around about here. So they're not, like, uber bad.
Here, this will help.
Good old Troy Baker, though. He's a huge, huge star now. I wonder if he kind of thinks that this is... I say a huge star. He's really big in games. Which kind of makes him a bit of a C-list celebrity, let's be honest. If you saw Troy Baker walking down the street, most people, apart from, you know, giant freaking nerds like myself are not going to probably know who he is. He's a fairly... he's a handsome chap, but, you know... you're not going to know him from Adam, really. But, in this industry, he's a big name. You know, he's in... in old The Last of Us, he's in Uncharted 4, he's in tons of stuff. And here he is doing a thing that BioWare have probably forgotten that they still do. Like, and he's still there, like, coming into the studio every few months, recording a crap load of new dialogue, and going, yeah, Star Wars stuff. Can I be in, like, one of your big games now? Which is not meant as a slight on old, the Old Republic, by the way. It's not a bad game, it's just a bit... it's a bit of the red-headed stepchild of the BioWare IP at the moment. You know, who really remembers the Old Republic? A load of people are still like, this game is still going? Yeah, it does. It's still going. Right. Hopefully this droid here won't take too long to deal with. Luckily they don't have a huge amount of health. I'm still eyeing up, or weighing in my mind, I should say, what I could be doing once I kind of like have done, worked my way through like the kind of BioWare IP stuff that's out at the moment. So basically once I finish this and Mass Effect Andromeda and Mass Effect 3, I'm just kind of trying to think, like, I want to do something a bit shorter pace, like, a bit shorter in length. But, open to suggestions. Okay, so. Let's make our way. Where are we headed? Okay, into there. Still not sure if this actually makes me run faster having my weapons drawn, but it feels faster, so that's good enough for me. Shit. Not faster though if I actually stop running. And that's the kind of great advice you can get when you watch my videos. Shit. Ah, bollocks. I was really hoping I wasn't going to run into anything. There we go. Ugh. There's always one. I wonder if this was towards the place we came with that massive walker. Is that Arkan? I didn't just hallucinate that, right? So how do I... I'm guessing this has got something to do with it? Okay, that... What? What am I doing? Like, what? Defeat the Iokath terminal network droids. Okay. What does this do? Do I have to put them in there? Okay. So you do that, and then what? Like, you know, you just keep doing you, Theron, just kind of keep that dude occupied. And I'm gonna do whatever this is. I'm not hallucinating. That was definitely Senya. Or I am most definitely going freaking mad. Well, I don't know what I did with those like little balls of energy, but it seems to have worked. Okay. I am now frozen. Make me unfrozen. Thank you. So I don't know if, like, I have more success by putting these things in that, what do you call it, and then killing them. But we'll see. So I'm going to focus my efforts on one droid on one side, and then move to the other, and then maybe finish the one off in the middle. That seems to make sense. Although, if Theron is just going to carry on being a fanny over there... Oh, excuse me. Theron? Oh, buddy, oh, friend. Do you want to, like, heal me? Theron! I'm still here! Health pack. Sod it. Right. If Theron's gonna be a massive fanny and not heal me, although he is healing me now, then I'm just going to focus my efforts on this middle one. And then we can work together as a team. Teamwork. It's a good thing. Right. Jump up there. Put that in there. Attack big beastie over here. No, I don't think so. Okay. Wow, now I'm running super duper fast. Ooh, this guy is undefended. Health going down somewhat rapidly. Okay, so that's one down. Do I still need to put the balls from here into the thingy over here, and then the other one on the other side over in the one on the other side, even though that thing is still alive? I don't know! It's somewhat unintuitive. I may be doing this the long way around, but what are you going to do? It's not as if they've told me how to do it. Okie dokie. Well, this one's not long for this world, to be fair. So let's now attack you. I'm kind of hoping that now that the other two are dead, that I don't have to keep contending with the shields on this thing anymore. Just let me kill it, for Christ's sakes. Like, stop trying to do arbitrary, stupid, like, game mechanics. Just let me kill the fucker. I know how to defeat him. He's not difficult. Just... Oh, for Christ's sakes. Tedious. And he was so close to being dead as well. How annoying. Result. Right, okay, so. What are we doing? So, I'm guessing we need to go to the door over here. I'm kind of still wondering why I was seeing Arkan and Senya. Pneumatic trams lore. Wow, I'm so interested to know what that is. Okay. You have discovered the Alliance Fleet Spire, so I'm guessing these are people on our side. It is indeed. Yeah, they're all on our side. Good. Oh, okay, this is like a hub. This is a thing that we can go to. Wonderful. Okay. Can I use my vehicle thing? I can as well. Alright, let's take a little walk around, shall we? Or a little fly around. Troop deployment console, what does that do? Hello, your forces are not ready for deployment. Oh, okay. So I guess that's like a little mini game that we can do. That's quite cool. Let's have a look. So, I quite like the like Imperial and Jedi symbol there. I'm actually thinking of having those as cufflinks. Getting married later on this year. And, yeah. Apparently, I'm informed by one of my best men that you're meant to have cufflinks when you get married. So, I have to go shopping. And I want to have a little bit of individuality on the old cufflinks. Because, you know, generic suit and that. Let's get some Star Wars shit in there.
Commander, welcome back to Iokath.
Ooh, we can be all romantic.
I hate it when work keeps us apart.
You love it, Theron.
At least the reunions are all the sweeter.
You didn't tell us you had company.
Ah...
Our trigger-happy friend sent these assassins, so I took them captive.
I told you I'm no assassin. I've come to deliver a message from the Republic.
And you are?
Captain Ilara Dorn. It's an honor to finally meet you, Master Jedi.
I apologize on Captain Dorn's behalf. Her attempts to pluck your Republic heartstrings are embarrassing.
Who are you?
Major Quinn. Advisors of the Empress and loyal servant of the Sith Empire. Like Captain Dorn, I come bearing a message.
Supreme Commander Malcolm wants a word with you, in private.
Empress Asena requests the same. But unlike Malcolm, she's open to a group conference.
So, Quinn is one of the Sith warrior companions. And I think Ilara Dorn is one of the... either the trooper or the smuggler companion, I'm not sure which. But yeah, Quinn actually at one point kind of betrays you, and you do get the option to kill him, I think, or at least to exile him. I can't remember. So how that plays out, if you do get to kill him, I don't know.
I have so many admirers and so little time.
We'll keep this brief.
Thank you for extending the Empire this honor, Commander.
The Republic's glad to see you. And my son, on Iokath.
Keep me out of this, Malcolm.
Wait, what? Enough.
Supreme Commander Malcolm. Empress Asena. Your armies have started a war over a superweapon of immeasurable power.
Hang on a fucking minute. That's Theron's dad. Satil Shan bumped Oakley's with that dude. Fair enough. Right, so, yeah, what the fuck are you guys playing
at? Why would you risk everything over a single weapon?
I take full responsibility for the Republic's actions, but I won't apologize.
This ought to be rich.
It's no secret the Eternal Empire nearly wiped out the Republic. We're struggling to rebuild and protect ourselves.
I dread to think what the other guy looks like.
It's the key to the Republic's survival. And I'll be damned if I'm gonna watch it fall into the Empire's treacherous hands.
I didn't come here to be insulted.
What are you getting at, Malcolm?
You once fought the Sith Emperor on his home turf. Now, you wipe out his legacy.
Join forces with the Republic. Help us defeat the Empire, and we'll share access to the superweapon. And all of Iokath.
Okay. So basically, pick the Republic or pick the Empire. I kind of like Empress Asena in that mission that we had with her in the last, in Knights of the Eternal Throne. I did quite like that mission. She seemed all right, but she is the Sith Empress, and yeah. I think what I'm going to do, as I have got a Jedi character and they are a good guy, I'm gonna probably side with the Republic, but siding with the Empire as my Sith character seems obvious. So we'll just see how it goes.
Malcolm's your father, Theron. What do you make of his offer?
He's right about the Republic. Vaylan nearly broke them. They need this.
The Empire suffered too.
We alone supported your battle against Vaylan, and we paid for it dearly. Now the Republic wants to deliver the killing blow.
You walked away from their corruption once before. Now, you can wipe the slate clean.
Why don't we take it?
Help us crush the Republic threat. Once they fall, our empires can both partake in the spoils of Iokath.
Yeah, Lana.
Lana, you know the Empire inside and out. What's your take on Asena's offer?
We've already allied with the Empire. If we turn against them now, what message does that send to the rest of our followers?
It tells them we don't honor agreements with traitors. Don't forget, she trespassed on Iokath without your permission.
A small transgression.
If I had to choose, I would join forces with the Empire.
Well, no shit.
The Republic's a safer bet.
The choice is yours, Commander. Who shall we side with?
Neither. Fuck the lot of yous. Oh, balls. Right, let's weigh this up, shall we? On one hand, the Republic are a bunch of tossers. No argument there. And it does kind of go along with my character's alignment. But the Sith Empire are our allies already. We are kind of in a thing with Lana, and I don't want to piss her off, but, and this is a big glaring but, they are Sith. And it goes against our character's alignment, and yeah, Sith, not the most trustworthy of people to be siding with. I'm going to go with the Republic.
We will ally with the Republic.
Glad to hear it.
A Jedi running to the Republic's defense. How predictable. Major Quinn, you have your orders.
For the Empire.
Bollocks.
He got away.
We'll deal with him later.
Commander, the Empire has launched a preemptive strike.
Fight back with everything you've got. We're on our way. Lana, Captain Dorne, defend this base while we hold off the Empire.
May the Force serve us all.
I really hope Lana's not going to hold this against us. That would be my hope. Right, okay, so let's get all of these. This seems like a fairly sensible place to end the episode. It doesn't seem to be split up into chapters like like the other expansions were. This is more of a game update, so I don't think it's kind of that traditional chapter 1, chapter 2 kind of thing. So I don't know when the next kind of logical respite's going to be. So I think we'll take it now. I think there's going to be a fair chunk of game to go. So I don't think the next part's going to be drastically shorter. And there may be even a third part. I really don't know. This is all new to me. So, yeah. We'll see how it goes. And I will see you in the next episode. If you do want to follow me on Twitter, it's at Jace Curtis. And if you want to see more episodes of both Star Wars The Old Republic, Mass Effect, whatever else I choose going forward, then subscribe to the channel, and if you've liked this video, then give it a like as well. But yeah, hope to see you in the next episode, and I will see you next time.